Islamic fundamentalists,
Islamic extremism,
an Islamic extremist group with reported ties to Al-Qaeda,
Islamists,
Islamic radicals,
radical Islam,
the Islamic fundamentalist,
moderate Muslims,
radical fundamentalist Islamic,
violent Islamic extremists,
radical fundamentalist
Muslim fanatics,
Islamic terror,
radical Islam,
radicalized American Muslims,
an Islamic extremist
terror group,
Islamic extremists,
Muslim American terrorism,
homegrown terror,
Islamic extremism,
radical fundamentalist Islamic,
terrorist act of war,
radical Islam,
war of radical Islam,
fundamentalist Islamic,
menace of radical Islam.
Oh, Muslims, let me tell you something that you should need to know. There's a report that's been put out. This report has been developed in America. It is what most of the governments in the world today are using as a ruler and a parameter to judge Muslims, to evaluate Muslims, to diagnose Muslims. And let me read to you what they have said concerning us. They, the so-called non-Muslim experts, have politically and ideologically grouped us into the following categories. They said that the Muslims of the world are of basically four different kinds. They're talking about Ta'ifiyah now. They are fundamentalists, they are traditionalists, they are modernists, and they are secularists. Let me define those terminologies for you. Fundamentalist means those people who are saying, we want to go back to the Quran and the Sunnah. We want to establish the Quran and the Sunnah. We want to follow the three generations of Islam. No, we do not want bid'ah. We don't want ghulu. We don't want excess. We want Islam, the Quran, and the Sunnah, and all our actions, and that's it. They call us, those who say that, fundamentalists. Although in Islam, there's nothing called fundamentalism. Then there are the traditionalists. These are the people who also say they follow the Quran and the Sunnah, but they hold on to a certain classical tradition. They say we are Wahhabi. They say we are Hanafi. They say we are Shi'i. They say we are Hanbali. They say we are Shafi'i. They say we are Maliki. Although those four men, Ahmed ibn Hanbal, Imam Shafi rahimullah, Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, although those are our fathers, those are our scholars, those are the mujtahideen of Islam and the greatest people who brought dalil to us from those generations, no doubt. But following them blindly as a tradition is what the category here is. People who follow them blindly, and therefore they don't unite with anybody else except those who follow each one blindly. They are called traditionalists. Then there are the modernists. The modernists are those who want to make a new interpretation of the Quran. They want to make a new interpretation of the Sunnah. They want to make a new interpretation of Islam. In fact, they are the people who may want to join all the religions together to have what they call peaceful coexistence. They are the people who call themselves Wahdatul Adiyan. That is, they want to join with all the religions together. Hinduism, Buddhism, Christianism, so and so, make it one all religion. It even sounds funny, don't it? Yeah, think about it. Hinduism, Buddhism, Christianity, Judaism, Brahmism, Shiism, Isheism. They want to bring all the religions all together with respect, and everybody want to go down the road together. We will overcome. See, that's what we want to do. This is called Wahdatul Adyan, making all, it sound nice, one world religion. I don't know who would be the head of that, maybe the Pope. They got the most money. Or it might be the mayor of Jerusalem. Or it might be Jacques Chirac. Or it might be Mr. Howard. Or it might be Mr. Bush. Or it might be whoever. We don't know who might become the leader of this new world religion. But the people who call for that among the Muslims, they are the misguided people, and they have joined the enemies of Islam. No matter how intellectual they are, no matter how sincere they are, no matter how educated that they are, they have joined the camp of the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they have said by doing so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not given to us the haqq. And that this deen of the Quran and the Sunnah and the wala and bara, the loyalty and the disassociation, the loyalty for the Muslims and the disassociation of the Kafirs, that there's nothing like that in Islam. We just go along down the road with whoever's happy with us, we happy with them too. Oh Muslims, they have come up also with a formula. Not only have they classified us, but they have also come up with a formula to deal with every category and how to create hostility and opposition between the different categories. They have determined that the greatest threat to Western civilization and the continued dominance of Western culture is to make sure that the Muslims never reestablish a global identity, and that there is no opportunity ever, ever, ever for them to reestablish the Khilafah. Let me repeat that point to you. They have determined that the greatest threat to Western civilization and the continued dominance of Western culture is to make sure that no nation among the Muslims develop among themselves a global identity. And secondly, they never, ever, ever have the ability to reestablish the Khilafah. Now, this is in their protocols. This is what you should understand. This is what they're preserving. This division is subtle and hidden, meaning that most Muslims wouldn't even know it. Therefore, it is more difficult to recognize than to treat. The non-Muslims who consider themselves as authorities and experts on Islam and Muslims have observed the following. Listen to this, please. The Muslims in the world are divided into the following basic socio-political groups: Asians, Arabs, Africans, those of the Far East, those of the Near East, those of European, American, and Australian backgrounds, although those are of the minority, those of Slavic and Russian backgrounds, although they are also a negligible population, and those of South America. This is what they said. Look how they divide us. Our objective is to polarize these ethnic groups. That means to keep these ethnic groups from uniting together and exploit their cultural differences. In this way, we can maximize our global agenda and we can minimize any global threat from them. Subhanallah. Look how clear they are. Look how bold they are. Look how blatant they are. And look how accurate they are.